everybody will be fairly entertained tonight. As everybody here is noticing, I have two microphones. And what we're going to try to attempt to do tonight is everything that's on this side of the stage, meaning all these folks over here, is going to come out of that side of the room. We have a typical PA system here, and then we have some other speakers that should sort of emphasize that side of the room. The same is happening on this side. Everybody who's on this side of the stage will be blaring at you from that side. And that's not usually very important when people are just playing music with instruments and stuff, but with this, it really lets you sort of hear the different dynamics from one side to the other. So anyway, what we've done is we've invited a lot of people who are in the band and people that we like and respect, and we asked them to come up and do this with us tonight. And usually we ask about 300 people, and only about two of us show up. But tonight, all these people have come up to help us do this tonight. So we're not going to ask for any volunteers from the audience, because we already have them up here. So anyway, I guess we're going to start. And does everybody have their bag of tapes? Yeah? Well, what we're going to start out with here is we're going to start out with a test. And what I want everybody to grab out of your bags is, yeah, it's this one. There you go. Yeah. Right. So what we want everybody up here to get out is this test. There's two tests in there. And what everybody guys is, you want to say test on. So what we're going to do, we're going to begin tonight with a couple of little test things. And what the tests are, really, is just we're going to yell at everybody up here to press play at the same time. And then if everything works right, each one of these tape decks will just simply count off in the right order. And I know that's not that big of a deal, but it allows us to see everything's working all right. And hopefully it will. And then we'll move on to some music after these first couple of tests. So, is everybody on your tapes? All right. Well, Michael, I'm going to get rid of this one here. You got me? So what we're going to do is I want everybody to turn the volume knobs all the way up. And the volume knobs on most of them should be pink. Right? And now, does everybody have the tape in there? You got your first test tape in there? What I'm going to do is I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, go. We bought all these tape decks, and in one day, we bought over 130 tape decks at pawn shops in Oklahoma City. And these are like the best ones of that lot. So some of them are great, and some of them are shit. But then I think a big variety of players is really the best thing we can have for this, because it gives you a lot of different dynamics. So anyway, what I'm going to do is I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, go. Now, sometimes people think when I say go, that they think I'm going to say go, and then press. But we don't want that. What we want you to do is when you hear even the very beginning of the good of the go, right? That's when you press. You don't wait for me to say go, and then press. As soon as you start to hear me say go, just press. And if you screw up, just press it again. It'll be fine. But I hope you don't screw up. Anyway, so, what I'm going to do, not yet, but I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, go. And once again, on the good of the go, and it's simply going to be a count off, and we'll see how it goes.
Go!
Right? Is he ready to go?
Go!
Then we can go begin. Are you ready?
Thank you.
is complex. To think is not entertainment, but then engage broadly. It is also a test to see if any further manipulation of sound equalization is necessary.
The test begins now. This is tape number one. This is tape number two. This is tape number four. This is tape number five. This is tape number six. This is tape number eight. This is tape number nine. This is tape number ten. This is tape number 12. Number 13. Number 14. Number 6 is 15. This is tape number 9. This is tape number 20. This is tape number one. This is tape number two. This is tape number three. This is tape number four. This is tape number five. This is tape number six. Number seven. This is tape number eight. This is tape number nine. This is tape number 10. Number 11. This is tape number 12. This is tape number 13. Number 14. This is tape number 15. Number 16. This is tape number 17. Number 18. This is tape number 19. This is tape number 20. This is tape number 21. This is tape number 24. This is tape number 24. Tape number 25. Number 26. This is tape number 27. This is tape number 32. This is tape number 34.
35.
This is tape number 36.
This is Mike going to the bar.
Number 37. This concludes the test portion of tonight's program. Thank you.
Stop those tapes. Okay, I thought most of that went good. Your back row, yeah, they didn't work out so well. But maybe they're gonna work out. I see. Some were late, some were early. Anyway, so put those tapes up, and the tape that we want you to get out and put in your tape deck is called the Big Old Bug. There you go. Show me there. It says Big Old Bug on. And what this song does is it lets you guys out there sort of hear just how expansive, if we've done this correctly, all this sound can be, because it starts off sort of one at a time building up, and hopefully it becomes a pretty insane, loud sound all around you. So we're going to see. So anyway, it seemed like all your guys are
number six.
I think he was on the one. Okay. Can we get one more? Is he one back? Okay. We'll do this one without him. Steve, you press it. We'll get it together.
Please see you number 16. Don't try to hide it.
Okay, and once again, using the 1, 2, 3, good, go method, we'll begin. Is everybody ready? Are you ready? Then we'll begin. Mr. Ivins, you ready to go? 1, 2, 3, go!
We have three dogs that love to choose stuff up. So we're always getting them some toys and stuffed animals and stuff so they can destroy it. And usually whatever we get is shred pieces within a couple of days. I noticed that the stuffed animal that we got had had for about a week and it had remained relatively unharmed. A little bit dirty, but it really didn't have any damage. So I was kind of watching it for the next couple of days. I noticed that for some weird reason, this little stuffed animal seemed like they all liked it for some reason, especially. And now they didn't, not only did they not chew it up, they sort of seemed like it was their baby.
Like they some sort of, like treated it as though it was their own baby.
So I thought, this is weird, how strange this is. Of all the toys and things you could get for it, for some weird reason, this one
wasn't really any different than the rest. This one was picked to be special.
So there you go. So some time passed, and one day I noticed that this box of big plastic insects that I've been keeping on shelf in the bathroom had somehow fallen down. And unfortunately,
it looked as though the dogs had already chewed up most stuff in big giant spiders
and hands. Cockroaches and stuff that were in it. And as I walked around the house picking up shredded pieces of
these plastic insects,
I came across the baby. You know, torn to shreds. Like everything else, all the other stuff, finally this one was torn to shreds. So later on, I came across one of the giant grasshoppers that for some reason
hadn't been chewed up at all.
Not even as much as a small tooth.
So I watched, and it occurs to me that for some reason,
their affections have changed. And I can plainly see that instead of the stuffed animal, the big old bug is the new baby.
and we're going to get out the one that says car accident. Should be that yellow one. On my side, I'll tell you this. Everybody? Car accident? Yeah? Yeah? And what we're going to do on this one is we're going to begin with all the volume knobs turned down. So go ahead and turn the volume down. So when we begin, there will be none of that hiss. It should just be quiet. And what we are going to do, Stephen on his side, and me on this side, my side over here, is we are going to guide you as to what you do with the volume knob. And what that really just means is we're going to say, when I do this, it means come up a little bit. If I do a little bit more, that means turn it more. And then I do that, that means go all the way up, come all the way down. We'll start off slow, and I think by time a critical part of the song comes out, you guys should know exactly what to do. It seems simple. Your volume's all the way down. And Miss Robbins, are you ready? Then we'll begin.
Thank you.
is going to take in just three songs into it. So anyway, go ahead, stop that tape, and we're going to put in the next one. The next one is called, on your tape there, it's called Speed of Light. And it should look something like, what's that green one?
Wait.
Yeah, it's like this, everybody. It's not like the tape of the car that comes out. It's
yeah, no,
and what we're going to do is we're going to use some of the same techniques that we used in the last song. But about in the middle of the song, we're going to start doing one at a time sort of things, and we're going to see how that sounds. And as we go, it'll be a little more complex, a little quicker. But I think from what we did just now, I think we're going to be fine. So anyway. Is everybody ready once again? All right, then we'll begin. Once again, volumes down. We'll start with volumes down. And we'll see what happens. Mr. Ivins, you ready to go? Michael, you ready? We will begin. Stay with us. One, two, three, go! Volume's down.
Take number one.
Thank you.
One, two, three, go!
Anyway. anyway, so get those tapes out. The next tape that we're going to put in is called Sunrise. Sir, it looks... The flight attendant, it looks like this. For you guys out there. Right? And once again, we're going to start with volumes down. And what I'm going to do on my side is I'm going to start in the back row. And I'm going to establish a rhythm in the back row. And then I'm going to go to the second row and establish another rhythm. And then another rhythm in the third row and get a different rhythm in the very top row. And like I said, these get more complex and difficult as it goes. So we'll see how it goes. Are you good, Mike? Michael, are you ready to go? So anyway, if anybody up here is needing to use the bathroom, we have this one and then one more. So hold on. Please hold on as long as you can. I'm giving you that hope. You know, if you knew we had another hour to go, you'd just go. But hold on for just a little bit longer. Anyway, once again, volumes are going to start down, and I'm going to start in my back row. If you're good with your mask, Mr. Ivins, you ready to go? Then we will begin once again using the 1, 2, 3, good, go, Betty. Steven, you ready to go? You guys ready? We will begin. 1, 2, 3, go! Thank you. That enemy caught me by surprise. And now that's the weird things on here. I didn't know which one was going to end up on which, but it was some bullshit. I think it was what we intended, yeah. Anyway, I thought that went all right. I mean, that's the first time we had that's the third time we've kind of redone that piece of music, or whatever you want to call it. So a couple of days, really even before we left to come over here, we left on Thursday, we hurried and we had some ideas of what we want to do, so we hurried and threw all these tapes together, and really we had no way of hearing it because all of our tape players were already over here. So we got here and we thought, what are we going to do? Because we kind of, we made it up real quick and thought it would work. And then you get here and you try to remember each piece. But I thought it went all right. I didn't know what was on your tape. Anyway, so we're going to do one more. And I just want to say thanks to everybody who came out. I know this is weird. I don't know what you expected. I hope you had an open mind and liked what was happening. But first of all, thanks to you guys. And thanks to the people at the forum for putting on the show. And after we get done, we'll thank all these people for coming up here and being brave and doing this with us. So anyway, the take that we're going to use is altruism. It's the last take. Do you want to go to him? Yeah? And what we're going to do on this last one is we have this stripe that goes down the middle. And what I'm going to do is you guys on this side of the stripe, we're going to be guided by this man. And you guys on this side of the stripe will be guided by this man. So it'll be this. Whatever this hand does, just see if you can follow. And the same over here. And we should be able to build a pretty intricate melody. From all the things that we've been through already tonight, I feel like you guys on this intricate but hard to do melody, We're gonna do this quick. So, once again, like I said, thanks to you guys. We'll thank all you guys when we get done. Of course, if it goes good. Anyway, Mr. Ivins, you ready to go? Oh, once again, volume's down. Start with volume's down. And for the last time, we'll be using the 1, 2, 3, good, go method. We will begin now.
Thank you.
knowing that you could have looked like such a fool. And maybe you did, I don't know, but thanks, really. You are really, thank these folks. Thanks again, everybody, for tolerating something that you didn't even know what was going to happen. So thanks again. And you guys, just put the stuff in the bag.